was like, she's really intuitive. So I sat with her and she was doing some muscle testing for me for my body health. Joe was at home. And all of a sudden my body was testing what Joe needed. And she's like, oh, that's weird. And so she tested. I think there's three different things that I was carrying as a carrier for Joe. And when I got home and I told Joe, and he was like, oh, that answers a question that I had. And, you know, my guides were telling me about my kidneys. And then, so he was like, it's just really interesting on how the universe will work. Cause sometimes they'll use other people as messengers for us. And when we're open to receiving in any way or being that person, that carrier for that knowledge, the bigger your world can become. And so there's also taking those chances and doing things that are new for you, just like you guys coming on board when you chose to come onto this meditation group, because it's not even a meditation. You don't know why so much that you're here, but you know that there's something there in it for you for as long as that you're here for it. And it's perfect to do it up to that point where you're like, okay, I'm done here. And then you carry on. There's so many things we can learn in this world, and there's not one way to doing it. Last night in our meditation group, it was a little bit different because, you know, there's the COVID rules of how many people you can have attend. And the space is quite small. And I was having requests coming up, like my phone was just buzzing. It's like, can I come to meditation? I was just like, what the hell? It's like, I think the list got over 15 people, and it's like, we're supposed to have like six or seven. And I just felt like I can't say no to anybody. I'm like, the universe is up to something. So I said, okay, universe, I say yes to everybody. You bring who is meant to come. And I started getting a little bit anxious, but I kept sticking to that. Okay, no, just let the universe do its job. And 11 people total were there for the group. And it was really good group. It was a really good energy. And there was new people there and everything. So it was just pretty cool, because I was telling everyone there in this talk that I do in the beginning here that not to get so far ahead of yourselves, or just catch it when you get too far ahead of yourself trying to make a plan of how you think it's going to be, because the universe can be very creative in how it wants to provide for you, and how Joe and I have been doing that for quite some time without really thinking about it. And it was Joe, you would say to me, just like, just don't worry about it. He says, let the universe deal with it. We'll see when we get there. Or why you, you know, don't look for the answer. Like, it will come to you. And he's like, I do it all the time. I trust in the universe. And he says it so matter of fact, you guys know, he'd be like, I just trust. And it just happens. And we're all like overcomplicating the process. And how I was saying last night is, it's like, try not to boss the universe around and say what your rules are to the game, and let the universe teach you. So like at the beginning of this week, we'll say starting on Monday, we had no sessions booked for the whole week. And it was up in the air. It's like, oh no, on Sunday, I said to Joe while we were driving home from the weekend, I said, are we going to go away for the following weekend to Nelson, another city where someone had asked us to come, but where we were, where Jackie lives and where we were planning on doing clearing sessions. The guy never got back to us, never answered our emails, never returned our phone calls. And so we're kind of like, well, then we're not going to go. And then it was like, but we felt that we were going to go. And on Saturday, I said to Joe, while we're driving, it's like, you think we're going to go to Nelson? And he's like, it feels like we should. And I was like, okay, well, by the time we had gotten home, I had already received a text message from someone in Nelson saying, hey, can you come? I can provide the space. I can set you up here. And then by the end of the night, the whole weekend opened up to potentials for bookings. okay, but we only had, let's say, 3 bookings over a 3-day period. So it's like, okay, well, maybe it's not enough time to get everyone together to do this. So Monday goes by and now I'm booked for Friday and for Saturday. Sunday's wide open. So Tuesday happens and I'm like really now booked on Saturday, just a little bit extra. And then, but Sunday's still wide open. So I'm saying to the group, and I said, I don't know if anyone's going to book at all, but I just give it to the universe to deal with. I'm available. And then as soon as I finished the talk, my phone buzzed and I looked down and it was someone saying, can I book on Sunday? And I was like, well, you see how fast the universe is responding to what it is that you need, or like what you're meant to be doing when you're in that flow with it. It's like, I'm being available. It feels like we should be going to Nelson. It's like, I don't know how it's all going to happen. And then within an hour, 2 hours, the phone calls start coming in and the appointments start coming in. It's like, I don't know what I'm going to be doing, but I'm available. And then they just come. It just happens. And that's Joe's trust in the universe and teaching me to trust and let go and not control how or when so much. And it's like being in the flow of it. And it, this whole week is starting to fill up with appointments when we had nothing on Sunday. And, you know, we kind of have like over 11 appointments this week and 0 on Sunday. So it can happen so fast. We just, you know, take one day at a time, one week at a time versus, okay, January, I'm going to have to do this. And March is going to have to look like this. And if you're in the flow and you're making the right actions for you at this time, everything's going to work out perfectly. And again, back to where we were there a couple weeks ago. And it's just like, and you know, those choices, they may be hard, but did you die? You know, like you're still here, you're still breathing, you're still making decisions. And we do have to go in things that are fearful and scary. And sometimes we just have to trust. And that's our lesson in itself, is just to trust.